Moja, Mbili, Tatu, and Zaire.
Lift every voice and sing till earth and heaven ring. Ring with the harmonies of liberty. Let our rejoicing rise high as the listening skies. Let it resound loud as the rolling sea. Sing a song full of the faith that the dark past has taught us. Sing a song full of the hope that the present has brought us. Facing the rising sun of our new day begun. Let us march on till victory.
But I want to take this time to welcome you again on behalf of the staff, the board of directors, the administration, and the management company. Welcome. I hope you feel like you're welcome. This is a great day for our 8th grade students, and I want to make sure that we make them feel like it's a great day. So let's give them another round of applause. On the stage with me, I want to make sure that I introduce them as well. So starting to my left, we have the middle school staff. Let's give it up for them. And that will be Mama Cece, Baba O, Mama Flo, and Baba D. Allen. So we also have Mama Smiley that's sitting over here, and Mama Rose. They're also part of the middle school staff, so let's give them a round of applause. Which is Mama Anthony, the curriculum coordinator for Timbuktu Academy. We also have the Infundishi Marvis Cofield, who's the board president. And we have Pastor Kenan Knox, whose house we are in, but he's also a board member on Manual of Educational Services. We have Alumni, who is the CEO of the management company, Manual of Educational Services. Jump. Is that right? Close. Close. Okay, gotcha. Thank you. the program. And the first thing is teacher reflections. So we're going to start off with Baba O, since he's been your teacher for the longest. So we're going to have him come up and start.
Thank you so much.
I'm about to go to you for those parents and families that don't know. I'm a math teacher, been here 6 years, I've enjoyed it. Been a great year. This year had some concerns about if whether or not the kids as eighth graders were going to buy into what we were doing, not only academically but culturally. Were they going to represent some of those values that we were trying to instill with them, both within the school and without them outside of the school? I can say that this year has been...
When you leave here, is a few lessons I taught you during the school year. One of those lessons was what I taught you in seventh grade when Bobby Moody's father died and I had to substitute for your LA class. It was a story about the three pigs, and they either built a straw house, a wooden house, or a brick house. And those who put the time in to build properly, when the big bad wolf came around, they was able to stand up to his huffs and puffs. You are now leaving the mamas and babas. You are now leaving the mama smileys who is gonna walk you through step by step. You're now leaving Baba O, who is gonna walk you through step by step, give you that history. You're now leaving me, who is gonna go over your test scores with you step by step. You're going into high school now. And really, this is level one. This was the foundation. And hopefully you walk away with a brick foundation and you continue to build on that. Second thing I want you to walk away with, especially since you're going into high school, and it's something I always stress to y'all, but y'all never got it, because y'all talk too much. You have two eyes, two ears, and one mouth. You need to look 40% of the time, you need to listen 40% of the time, and express yourself 20% of the time. That's just basic mathematics. Everything that look good is not good. Trust me. And then you have people that know how to talk well that will swindle you out of everything you have. So you have to look, listen, and observe their actions. Last but not least, I want you to remember how valuable you are. The first lesson I taught you this year was all that your parents went through, all your grandparents went through, all your ancestors went through, just for you to be here in this one moment, right now. It's over 100 million seeds that come out to reach that one egg. And you are that one seed and one egg that made it to be here right now. That's a miraculous thing. That was harder to do than hitting a lottery. So if you recognize that you are a miracle, you will walk with value and purpose. So remember that. If you remember those three things, I know you're going to be all right. Peace.
Awesome. That was powerful. That was powerful.
Timbuktu family and friends, I'm Mama Flo and my middle school students already. Y'all already know. I don't even have to say it. I did my homework. Mama Shrine said, make sure you have something to say, and I got a lot to say. I had to condense it. So. First thing I want to say is I'm so proud and honored to be up here. You're the first eighth grade class, and I've taught many middle schoolers, but I've never been able to go to the graduation and see them actually walk across stage. I'm so honored right now, especially that you have. Two, I want to reflect, but I also want to give you a message. The first thing I want to reflect on, everything I ever taught was for you to be able to use it in life. When you line up at my door, the first thing you had to do was do what? Shake my hand, give me eye contact, and say, good morning. Not because I'm trying to be a stickler, but so that I can prepare you, not for a job, but for a what? A career. A career is something that you love and that you actually enjoy going to. Yeah, you're gonna have some jobs in the future, but I'm preparing you for your career. So with that being said, I have three values and principles that I think that you're gonna need for the rest of your life, not just for high school, but for the rest of your life. Y'all ready for them? All right. So, first thing is, everybody say money?
Money.
It means faith. I know you heard this before, right? Oh, okay. So, students, get better at trusting yourself. You have had times where you've doubted yourself. I need you to trust yourself. Because you're going into high school, a lot of people say, I know who I am. You know who you are also. Don't ever let anybody tell you that you're not good enough. I know you're good enough. If you think you can, you can. Matter of fact, we don't say think in my room. We know, right? So I'm sitting over there, I did Class Dojo, so I want this for the last time. And the name that came up was Christian Stalling. So Christian Stalling, you're gonna lead us in our last Class Dojo, right? We're waiting on you. I know.
I know I can be where I want to be.
By who?
God.
Who did it every day. Because I know you can, and you gotta believe you know you can. Trust in yourself. There's nobody in the world that's perfect. The only thing you can be perfect at is being perfect you. The perfect you. Y'all understand? Second value and principle that I wrote down is Coochie Chocolier. Everybody say it? Self-determination. Be as persistent as you can and don't give up. You're gonna have a lot of assignments where you're like, oh my God, I feel like middle school all over again. Mama Flo made us write all these papers. The papers gonna keep coming like this. Don't give up. You have resources. You have resources. You have resources. You have resources. Just because you move on don't mean that we stop being resources. How do you do it? Remind yourself to always be present, AKA focus. I say that all the time, stay focused. The same initiative you give me for Sparkle and Ultimate Sparkle and Blur and how confident you were and like I walked that homework path, feel that same way about that diploma. You understand? Last core value and principle. Everybody say, I have four, sorry. Emoji, unity. A family helped mold you into the beautiful individuals that you are. A family is going to continue to be on you about being the best person you are and to help you obtain your dreams. So with that being said, this is a family and this is a team. Remember, I'm here for you and I got you. If you need a paper edited or feedback, I got you. A shoulder to lean on, I got you. If you need somebody to listen to you, I got you. I will forever be your mama Flo. Don't you forget it. I love y'all. Y'all. Don't laugh at me, George. You know I said I wasn't gonna cry. I love y'all. I love y'all, for real. And I'm proud of y'all. Congratulations, class of 2018.
Thank you.
Mama Rose and Mama Smiley an opportunity to come on up. If you do not want to speak, you don't have to. Mama Rose, you pass like Mama Smiley's trying to. I don't see Mama Rose.
Right?
Oh, okay. Come on up. Followed by Mama Zeta. Come on up.
Have the opportunity to work with the eighth graders. It's been a blessing to see all y'all just growing. I really enjoyed everyone. I don't have any specials. I really enjoyed everyone, especially Mercedes.
Is she here?
No. Okay. Well, everything has been so beautiful. I wish you all the luck in the world, and I know you can do it. Thank you very much for the opportunity. Thank you. We don't want to underestimate anybody
But these young people right here, they can do so much more. And I don't even know if they know it. They know they can work together, but there is so much more that you can accomplish. Just like Baba Diallo says, you all have to learn to be quiet and listen and see things clearly. See it clearly before you move. Plan based on what you've actually paid attention to, not just jumping in, because y'all got each other's back. You got each other's back, but you need to have each other's back for the right things. You need to be focused and strong together for those things that are going to build you up, lift each and every one of you up to your highest potential. I'm so proud of what you have achieved so far, and I'm looking forward to hearing about your stories through social media, through your visits, through those calls when you need assistance to get over the hump, knowing that you got over that hump, because you can and you will, and I'm so proud of you. Congratulations.
Y'all anyway. love you all. There's no such word as can't, because whatever you put your mind to it, you can do it. Don't allow anyone to control you from where? From the outside. Say it, George.
Outside.
From the outside. You know how to control yourself from where?
Yes.
From the inside. That's the one thing that I taught them. I taught them that in fourth grade. I love each and every one of you. Don't allow anyone to control you from the outside, because you can control yourself from the inside. It don't take much. You know the difference between right and wrong? Make the right choice. It's not hard to do. I love you all, and I'm still going to get y'all one way or another.
These are two that were selected to speak. Aww. And we're going to start with Miracle. Christian will be
acting. Hi. Today we are here to celebrate all the accomplishments and hardships as students of Havoc Curve. Our eighth grade class have been through ups and downs and shared many personal memories, fights, and laughs with each other. Some of us felt as if we are more than classmates, but close family. So, I wish you all success and comfort as we all proceed into a high school life without each other. May you never stop trying and working hard to be the best version of yourself. And I know that we will not find the same love, support, and comfort as we do here in Tema 2, but I also hope that you will find friends and teachers that will lift you up with the same support, and perhaps even more than Tema 2 did us. I wish you students who got expelled from Tema 2 from bad behavior to not shame yourself for their actions, but to reflect and learn from their mistakes and move on from it. I also hope that those teachers who have lost sleep, quality time, and sanity just to prepare me for the future years knows that I appreciate their work, and I wish them the best careers after us. We all personally thank this school for giving us a place to laugh and school safe and protected where we are. Thank this school for giving us knowledge, a small sense of self-identity, countless of chances to get better, and for some of us, a family. It was difficult making it through the eighth grade year together, but we did it. I love you all. Let's not take on into my two family in eighth grade.
Those value systems. At this time, Baba Ola Tunji is going to come up He's going to explain or present the certificates. I can actually do the explanation for him. So every Monday, we sing the circle, and in Guzo Saba, Umoja stands for what?
Unity.
Unity. Kuji Chakalia?
Self foundation.
Ujima?
Ujamaa?
Nia?
Purpose.
Kumba?
Creativity.
And Imani?
Faith.
So, based on those seven principles, the teachers have awarded this eighth grade class certificates based on what they displayed throughout the year. So if you could come on up, Baba. Oh.
This year was the first year, just like Mama Shawanda said, that typically the teacher will kind of assess the performance of the student throughout the year, which of these cultural morals have they exhibited throughout the school year, knowing that they're not going to be perfect, but which one of these were they able to really hold on to and exhibit, and hopefully we can get them to exhibit all seven principles. However, this particular year, I decided that students make a decision and decide which of these principles they exhibit and they saw and found within themselves, which is what we always believe in African-centered education. We believe that the greatness is already within the child. It's just our job to point it out to them. And so that's what I gave them the opportunity to do. So of course, I had some students that arbitrarily just wrote their name on all the principles. And there were some students that were a little bit more selective as to what particular attribute, what particular principle they felt that they exuded, and what particular principle they felt that they had seen the greatest progress in. That being said, the first student receiving an award in Umoja, Kaumba, Imani, Nia, Kuji Chakalia, Miracle Ray Davis. This student chose Umoja, Imani, Ujamaa, Nia, and Kuji Chakalia, Michael Farnbill. Jadae Haniel, she chose Kaumba, Imani, and Umoja, and lastly, Nia. Imani, Nia, Kuti Chakalia, Kaumba, and Ujamaa, MJ, Marala Johnson. Faith, that being Imani, Nia, Purpose, and Kuti Chakalia, Self-Determination, Ayana Kerr.
Ayana!
Imani, Ujima, Nia, and Kuti Chakalia, Tayshawn Kerr. This student was definitely creative, and I think all the other students would agree. Kaumba, Imani, Umoja, and Kuti Chakalia, Dorian Lava. The next, Kaumba, Imani, Ujima, Nia, Michaela Martin. Imani, Ujima, and Ujamaa, Annie McKinney. Kaumba, Imani, Ujamaa, and Kuji Chakalia, Eminem, Mariah Carey. just like I said, there were some students that have been given an opportunity, they could identify what they wanted, and some selectively, consciously decided, I'm going to do this one and two and three. She started from the left and worked all the way to the right. Moses Richburg, Jamal. So we were Jamal and we Jamal. Imani, Kuumba, and Ujima, student with the biggest head, George Rutherford.
George!
Not wrong. Check that out, brother. Ujima, Kujitake, Ujima, and Nia, Jason Patrick.
JP.
Dominica Shorter, choosing Ujima and Imani.
Dominica, grown up, girl.
Christian Stallings, Imani, Ujima, Ujima, and Nia.
Christian!
Kujitakalia, Ujima, Kuumba, and Imani, Darrell Witherspoon.
Darrell!
Now, as I'm sure some of the students noticed, there were some students that weren't called, and these students received the Imuzasaba Award, which basically says that they represent all aspects. As I said before, they weren't perfect, but how I judged it, every time I asked them to do something, they were able to do it. They may not always have met my expectations, but they tried. They were always willing to help the other students. They were always working in the hallway. They were always in the lunchroom. They were always doing those things that, as an African-centered school, we try to make sure that those students put forth to the forefront of how they interact not only with themselves, the teachers, but also with their peers. The first person receiving the Imuzasaba Award, Jaden Gellman. Next, Danielle Nye. Rotika Smith.
Rotika.
And lastly, Alicia Rock.
The values that the parents have taught them. So give the parents a round of applause. So at this time, I also want to recognize the people that have been with us since kindergarten or first grade. So if you've been with us since kindergarten or first grade, please stand up so you can be recognized. Jaden Elliott, raise your hand. Jadae Hamill. Mariah Johnson. Darrell Witherspoon. And Mariah Moore. Awesome. So there's two more people that I want to recognize since we're doing special recognition, and that is Rotika Smith. Stand up. Come in. welcome us to his house, but also give you all some words of wisdom. So please give your hands together for Pastor Mike.
Jumbo. Jumbo. There we go. We're good. We're great to be here today. We want to take this opportunity to thank the entire staff, Mama Sharonda, and the staff of Timbuktu Academy for selecting MHAP Church to have this great commencement. We're grateful for the promotional ceremony. We honor Board President Odishi Marcus Cofield, Magnum Educational Services CEO Bernard Parker, and we thank all of you, the parents, who really are the heroes of the story. You're the hidden figures, amen. You know, I'm still at church, so y'all pray for me. I believe you're the hidden figures. You're the reason why your babies have made it thus far. And I want to give you just a little bit, just in my couple of minutes, I was sitting back and thinking, what can I tell you? And I want to bring you a message from June 2022, because you're now graduating from the class of 2018 to become the class of 2022. So I want to bring you a message for 2022. I need to know, are you ready to be the graduating class of 2022? Will you have the focus necessary to stay on task, target, and on time? Will you have the determination to make sure that you don't hang in the wrong crowd to get you distracted from arriving in June 2022? Will you continue to listen? Will you be ready to listen to your parents, ready to listen to your instructors, ready to listen to everything that these great staff have taught you over these years that you've been at Timbuktu Academy? Will you be ready? Because I went to the future and I brought back some information on who's ready. Can I tell you who's ready? The colleges are ready to write the letters to let you know you've been accepted.
Okay.
The ink is ready to be on the paper. The paper is ready to be mailed. Your mom, your dad, your grandma, Big Mom, Pookie, Ray Ray, they're waiting to buy tickets or to get the tickets to whatever venue your graduation is going to be at. The stage is already ready. It was built for you. It was built to hold your dream from the built the day you walk across the stage. It's ready for you. The sound system, the sound you. But my question to you, will you
be ready?
Be ready? Will you be ready to put away the phone and pick up the book? Will you be ready to put your head towards your goals and away from the distraction? Will you be ready to grab that brass ring and to reach for your goal? Will you be ready? Because everybody else, we're all in the future waiting to be ready. Will you be ready? Who's going to be ready? Who's ready for 20? Who's going to do everything it takes to be ready for 2022? Is 2022, tell somebody, 2022 is waiting on you.
Waiting on you.
Now look at just the person next to you. I know y'all don't know the neighbor thing because y'all not really surprised, so y'all don't know church stuff. But turn to your neighbor and look at them and say, 2022
is waiting
on you.
On you.
Timbuktu. Glory to God. I am excited. So last time I'm gonna leave you with them, I'm taking my seat. I promise I'm gonna sit down. But I need you to repeat after me. All I do
is win.
No matter what. Focus.
On my mind.
I ain't never giving up. Every time I step. Up in the building. Everybody's hands go up.
Okay.
And they stay there. You stay there, and 2022 will be waiting for you. God bless you.
Okay.
So Infundishi just told me that Pastor Knox had a son. Actually, they graduated with my son this year from Cass Tech. $250,000 in scholarship.
giving it out. Mercedes is here, I understand. Yay. Is she? All right, stand up so you can be recognized. You didn't get to come in. And you also have some Google Cyber Awards up here.
Came in sneaking in hiding in the back of the Cadillac always do. You must have slept in like you normally do on the other regulars. Well, you know I slept in. Come on up here. Mercedes, and I can say she definitely at one of the particular parentage conferences we had, there was a revelation that was revealed that sometimes she don't always like getting up in the morning. So because of that, we had some challenges with her making it to first hour, because the first hour she had math. And her mother and I, and Mercedes, we both agreed, all three of us, that she would do a better job in getting up or have a greater consequence when she came to see me or when I found her during the day. But she earned and demonstrated Imani, Ujama, and Nia. Mercedes, Cadillac Robinson.
The CEO of Magnum Educational. Everybody always asks me, like, who runs the school? He does. Who's the boss of the school? He is. Let's give him some CFAS he comes up. Woo, 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 woo.
Bargain.
Well,
first of all, congratulations to the class of 2018. That you should be very proud that of this promotion that you're going to the ninth grade to high school. We're very proud of you. We're always sorry to see our eighth graders leave, but we're very pleased when they come back to see us. Please come back and visit, come back and ask any questions you may have, particularly when times get a little tough and you just need to talk to somebody. We're there for you. But before I go on, I would like all the parents, guardians, grandparents, of any of the graduates to stand up. Now I would like all eighth graders to stand up and face your parents. And give them a big hand for all they have done to get you here. Thank you. I just want to leave you, but one thing I want to say that I don't know if I've been shared with you yet, but every year our authorizer with DPS, Detroit Public School, gives us certain guidelines or targets that we must meet. I am very proud to say that the eighth graders met that target in reading.
Awesome!
A little short math, but you definitely met that in reading. And reading is very important because if you can read, you can learn anything. And you can use that when you get to high school and hopefully when you go on to college and vocational training. But the one thing I want to say to you is elementary school and middle school usually are small. Everyone knows everyone. Everyone is friendly with everyone and there's not a lot of pressure. You're getting ready to go to ninth grade. There's going to be some 12th grade senior athletic person that is well known that is going to be coming to try to talk to you. Please, don't listen to what they say and totally. Don't do anything they ask you to do. Because many times that they want to take advantage of you, they're waiting for the ninth graders to come in to take advantage of them. That doesn't mean you have to be cold to them and don't talk, but don't do anything they ask you to do while talking to your parents or your teachers if it's something particular. It's how you select your friends is how you're going to be successful. You select your friends based on the common things you have in common, being in ninth grade together, maybe living in the same neighborhood, maybe having some of the same things that you like. Those are the ones you need to become friends with and grow into the high school years. Do not get sucked in some of the older students that are going to come to you with all kinds of stories and things that are going to be very attractive. And you not knowing me is sucked into it. Just leave it alone. Don't be there. Go with your friends, the people that you know, or the people that are in your class, and move gradually up to one day when you'll be a senior there, and hopefully you'll give the same respect to the ninth graders when you're coming in. Again, congratulations on your promotion going to ninth grade, and good luck to you in high school.
Just graduated from Cass Tech. So Janiyah, where are you? So not only is she a Cass Tech graduate, but Janiyah has come back every year to help with our Kipe Peyo mentoring program for girls. So that's 4 years after she's graduated that she has come back and helped out with that program. At this time, I want to recognize all of our Kipe Peyo sisters. So if you have on the Kipe Peyo head wrap, stand up, come on up, Mama Zaina, Mama Jazz. So at this time, we have necklaces that we want to present to them because they have been with us some since fifth grade, some since sixth grade. Yes, I just asked them all to come up. So, myself, along with Mama Zaina and Mama Jazz, every other Saturday for the past 5 years, have mentored a group of girls, and this just so happens to be the girls that we mentored through the eighth grade this year. Let's give them a round of applause. So what Kipe Peyo's intention is to give them experiences that they might not have if they hadn't been a part of the group. So in addition to teaching what it's gonna be like to be a woman, we also give them real life experiences. We take field trips. We talk about keeping yourself accountable, being responsible for your actions, making sure that you're taking care of the community and your family first. And I hope that there were some things or some lessons or experiences that we share with you all that will really make an impact on your life. So as they're getting their necklaces pinned on them, I can also talk some more. So, with Shamiah here, although she's the mean one to us, she doesn't really want to come, but she comes every other week anyway, just to give us attitude. We love you. MJ is our Miss Sassy here. She wants to be a model of some sort. She thinks it's a picture shoot every time we get together. She takes all of our phones and puts her pictures in them. Mariah and Jade, they said they just come to eat mainly because we eat. Dominica came because her mother made her come. She did not want to come. She even told stories like, they said it wasn't no Kipe Peyo this week, so she couldn't come. Ayana came and participated, but she didn't speak much. I think she was coming to be with her friends. Like, I'm just gonna come because they come. So Ayana, I really hope that you got something out of it. And last but not least, Mercedes. So she was the one that just floated in, like Baba O said. So she'll come sometimes, she won't come sometimes. But she stuck it out, and I wanna make sure that we look at these young ladies, because just like Janiyah did, came back to help out with the younger students, we want you to do the same thing. So has everybody been, not pinned, but their necklace has been put on them? Awesome. Let's give them one more round of applause, and now we're going to start our slides. So those on the stage, you just have to get off the stage so that you'll be able to see up there. Mama Pam and Baba Zen, this is a shout out to you. Thank you for doing the slideshow. We appreciate it. Today by Malcolm X, and it also says that you have successfully completed the required course of study for the 8th grade at Timbuktu Academy. All right, so I will be over here waiting on my boss. So,
all right, here we go. Miracle Ray Davis. Jaden Elliott. Michael Farmer. Jadae Hannah. Mariah Johnson. Ayanna Kirk. Tayshawn Kirk. Danielle Knott. Dorian Lyles. Michaela Martin. Annie McKinney. Mariah Moore. Shemaya Moses Richburg. Jake Patrick. Mercedes Robinson. George Ruffin. Dominica Shorten. Rotika Smith.
That's a cute picture.
Christian Stallings. Darrell Witherspoon. Alicia.
So do me a favor, just make sure that you have your right certificate. When he called names, I forgot Donovan wasn't here, so it may have been a little out of order by one. Everybody good? Christian, you good? Rotika Hedrus, all right, cool. I didn't mess up all the way, it was just those two. So on behalf, again, of the school, Timbuktu, the board, the staff, the faculty, I just want to say congratulations to the class of 2018. So we traditionally do not have eighth grade dance, junior prom, as you all kept saying it. But because of the tight-knit connection that this class had, and they worked together to, I guess, accomplish certain goals, so they came, they asked, we bartered, they learned how to ballroom with Mama Smiley. And so in order to have a junior prom spring dance, they had to learn how to ballroom. Let me just tell you how pleased I was with them. It made my heart smile to see them come up dressed like high schoolers, acting like mature young people. Not once did I have to say, hey, what's going on over there in that circle? They wanted some ballroom. They wanted them to play ballroom music. They wanted to get out there and dance. They had a good time. And I really, really just enjoyed this eighth grade class. And I don't say that to all. I'm sure the people that have been here know I don't say that. So I am truly going to miss you, but make sure that you give it your all to be the perfect you. Good, better, best. Never let it rest. until your good is your better and your better is your best. Always remember that.